क्लास 10 स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई विल डू लोकस। द लोकस ऑफ ए पॉइंट इक्विडिस्टेंस फ्रॉम टू इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन्स इज द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ द एंगल्स बिटवीन द लाइन्स। दिस इज द थियोरम ऑफ लोकस। नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस। The locus of a point equidistant from two intersecting lines. So, let us draw two intersecting lines. Let's say AB and BC. Sorry, AB and CD are two intersecting lines. The bisector of the angles between the lines. If you bisect this angle. Let's say you are bisecting. You know how to bisect. From here if you draw one arc, and from here if you draw another arc, and from here another, then join this and produce, then it will be the bisector. Let's say KL, LK. So this LK is the, LK or KL is the locus satisfying this condition. Similarly, if you bisect this angle, join this, this is another locus with the same condition. Let's say M N, this M N is another locus. What was the condition? Condition was that equidistance from two intersecting lines. So A B and C D are two intersecting lines. They are bisected, their angle bisector of the angle, bisector of the angle between the lines will be the locus. So LK is one locus and MN is another locus. This is the theorem. Another theorem, it is given the locus of a point equidistant from two given points. Let's say A and B are two points is perpendicular bisector of the line joining the two points. So the locus of the point equidistant from two given points, that means let's say two given points, this A and B, you join this, they are bisected. That means if you bisect the line AB, that means from A one arc and from B another arc, you join this two, let's say you are getting MN. So MN is the locus. What is the meaning? That on MN, any point if you take, let's say here is the point, and distance between A and distance between B will be equal. That means this distance equal to this distance. Again, let's say I am taking one point here. So this point to A and this point to B will be equal. This distance equal to this distance. Anywhere you, let's say here you are taking, so this distance equal to this distance. This is the locus because MN is the locus. Now the same thing, the previous theorem also, any point on this bisector, let me draw this diagram again. Any point on this, so these are two line. If you draw the bisector of this line, let's say I am drawing the bisector. So any point on this bisector will be equidistant from the two lines. That means you draw perpendicular on this line, are perpendicular on this line, these two distance will be equal. Similarly, let's say here is the point, you draw perpendicular here, and here also you draw perpendicular, these two distance, this and this will be also equal. Similarly, any point you take here, perpendicular you draw, that two distance also will be equal. These two distance, these two theorem you have to memorize and understand so that you can do sums of this locus. Let us do one sum. Given PQB is perpendicular bisector of the side AB. So AB is the side and PQ is the bisector of the triangle ABC. Prove that Q is equidistant from AB. Now this proof means with the statement, theorem statement you can prove that since PQ is the perpendicular bisector of AB, so So PQ is the locus. On this locus, on the any point you see, this, if you join this point, this is equal. Similarly, Q is any point on the locus. If you join AQ and BQ, so these two also will be equal, like the previous theorem I told you. So this thing you have to write. What you have to write? That since Q is on the perpendicular bisector of AB, therefore PQ is the locus. And any point on the locus is equidistant from A and B. Now Q is a point on the line A and B, Q is a point on the line PQ, therefore Q is equidistant from A and B. Therefore AQ equal to BQ, this you have to write. See, I have written that since PQ is perpendicular bisector of AB, therefore PQ is the locus. Now any point on the locus is equidistant from A and B, therefore Q is equidistant from A and B. So this is the sum. Now sum number 2, given PQ is the bisector of angle C of triangle ABC, prove that P is equidistant from AC and BC. So matter is same like theorem second theorem. Since CP is the bisector of angle ACB, so any point on CP, so CP is the locus. Now any point on CP is equidistant from the side AC and BC. Now P is any point on the bisector, angle bisector. So P is equidistant from AC and BC. That we have to write. See, I have written this thing. Whatever I told, I have written here. So that's all.